So I'm talking to you this week about fears. I want to see one of my biggest fears. Hey ladies! Welcome to the third episode of Ladies Aboard. I do want to personally apologize. I know I'm a couple days behind on releasing the episode, but truth be told, everywhere I've tried to go to record this segment where I do my talky bit, it's been really, really windy and it just keeps picking up on the camera. So I'm really, really sorry about that, but let's see if I can get this pumped out today. Otherwise, again, I also apologize for the music in the background. There's the Tiki Bikini Hut in Nassau here is just blasting tunes all day, so nothing much I can do about that. But hey, now I don't have to put the music in the edit. So this week, I'd like to talk to you about one of the biggest things that I had to worry about before I left. And even now, to this day, I'm still worried about this, and it's, you know, that thing called fear. Before we left, you know, all the time, anybody knew finding out about this venture we're about to embark in, everybody's like, aren't you scared? Like, you're leaving everything behind, you're doing that, like, you're scared, you gotta be scared, right? Yeah, I'm scared, and to this day, several months into the journey, I'm still scared. So I want to talk to you about that, about the fears of, you know, doing this thing. So to start, my number one fear was leaving everything I knew behind. I mean, my security of a job, the roof over my head, my friends, my family, like, ugh, I'm showing them that there's more to life than just, you know, whatever it is that everybody back home is doing. I don't know. I mean, no offense at all when I say, you know, it's just, I wanted something more out of my life, and I met somebody who was able to, you know, help me see to that, to see through, you know, getting out of Dodge and living this amazing life on a boat of all things. And do I regret it? No, not even a little bit. No regrets whatsoever. But that kind of leads me into the next thing, is the being a girl on a boat with my boyfriend, whom I love and adore very much. Just some days I meet my girlfriends, or, you know, my sister or my mommy. Like, I'm a girl, I need my girls. You know, I got my tight-knit group back home, between my family and my friends, and not having them here by my side, it's really hard sometimes. But try not to get all emotional about it. sorry. But hey, joys of being a lady on board. There's no secure money support system. I mean, yeah, we're making some money with our videos and some things here and there, and, you know, selling things that we realize we don't actually need, or whatever the case is. And yeah, but at the end of the day, the money goes a lot quicker than it's coming in. So, and especially, you know, we almost sunk. We almost lost this boat. We almost lost everything that we invested all of our time and energy into. We almost lost it all in one fell swoop. And what do you do? We don't have insurance. That's a question we're asked a lot. And I can tell you right now, truth be told, we don't have insurance. We're self-insured, so to speak. And that's something that we have to deal with. So then, what else is there to worry about? There's the fact that I'm living on a sailboat. And I mentioned in the first episode, I've never sailed a day in my life up until I met Tim. And I'm, mind you, I did grow up on a powerboat. I did. And I'm very thankful for that. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't have the stomach for this like I do. But I've never sailed. So when, you know, the heel gets going, it's like, it's terrifying. It's scary because it's like, oh my God, what if this breaks? Oh my God, babe, how heavy is our keel? How heavy is our keel? And to this day, months and months into it, I mean, we've owned this boat for almost 3 years now. And there's still days where my stomach's in knots because, you know, I feel like we're heeled over too much. And I'm like, oh, it's been a while since we've done this. And it happens. Touching base on the fact that we almost lost this boat and everything on it. And we didn't. Because we worked together, Tim and I worked together, we saved the boat, we made it through, and sure, the money was a thing because we had to replace a lot of electronics, a lot, and it was cool, big money, but we're still here, we're still doing this, we're still going, and there's nothing that can stop us, and that's pretty amazing. This week we hop on board a catamaran named Avalanche, which is a Gemini 105MC. And today we are hanging out with Julie aboard Avalanche. So tell me Julie, tell me about Avalanche.
So Avalanche is a catamaran sailboat, Gemini 105MC. And she's 34 feet by 14. Decent size, yeah.
She's bigger in the hips than our boat.
Exactly. We're like a full figure girl.
Why? Why are you living on a boat right now?
So, I'm 4'10" and a half. And we're from London, Ontario, which gets a lot of snow. So it was fun
She is shorter than me.
It was fun going through the snow every day.
And
my husband, we both hate the cold, we both hate the snow, so we were like, how can we get out? So after looking at living in different countries, everything was just really expensive. A boat could take us different places until maybe we find a place that we like.
I think that makes sense.
Yeah.
I like that.
And get out of the cold.
Yeah. Number one, get out of the cold. Number two, where can I work?
Right.
Or potentially work, eventually.
Eventually.
I like that.
Exactly.
I don't know. The questions I could ask. Because you're on a cat.
Yes.
And personally, being a monohull girl.
Right. Let's fight. When we were looking for a boat, we looked at a lot of cats. We looked at monohulls. And while monohulls definitely do get you a good bang for your buck.
Yeah.
I'm actually legally blind. And my balance is like... the nice thing about a catamaran versus a monohull is that it's quite flat.
And you can kind of not play with that.
Yeah, right? I've been on a monohull and heeled and been like, oh my God, clinging for dear life. Catamaran, I'm much flatter and I feel much more secure. It's easier to walk through the catamaran and have that space.
I can appreciate that. Yeah. Word on the tide is that you're heading back north.
Right, yeah.
Why?
As a 4'10" woman who's legally blind and had a stroke, I can do a lot. I can lift the anchor, I can do the prop, I can do the rudders, etc.
Gonna give her that right now.
Anyone with medical conditions, always consult your doctor.
Yes.
We went to my neurosurgeon first and got the okay.
The okay for you to...
For me to travel before we did.
That's important.
Like,
what do you do for medication?
Oh,
for this,
no.
For that?
No, we went to the doctor with a list of medications we wanted. Sean went to his, my husband, and then I went to mine. We got painkillers, we got it coming in, got it going out, suture kit. You know, we got EpiPens. Neither of us has allergies, but you never know. Bugs you're gonna run
you
into. What you're gonna eat.
You don't know if you're allergic to that bug.
Exactly.
But if it bites you and you
exactly right. So when people don't think of getting EpiPens.
That's smart. I didn't think of that. Good on ya. Is there anything else that you want to talk about specifically?
Vodka or rum, any 40% alcohol,
yep,
will get you clean, kill the bacteria and everything.
Okay. I'd rather drink it and stay dirty for an extra day.
That's the pirate life.
Regardless whether she's going back home, she's not going back home, I don't know. We'll find out, I guess. Because stay tuned on their channel.
Quit work, be happy.
Quit work, be happy.
Check it out, please.
YouTube, go get it. Bam!